Alright, happy Monday. Hopefully everyone had a good weekend. For today's class, we're working with dumbbells. We have a upper body block and a lower body block. Each only 5 exercises. And then we're gonna finish with a core block as well. Again, 5 exercises. So only 5 exercises in every block. We're gonna do each block twice. Before moving on to the next block, but it's on a descending rep count. So 10 reps of everything on the first round, 8 reps of everything on the second round. Because we're working with weights, it's going to be kind of a little bit less cardio, more strength. So we're going to have a little bit of an extended warm-up that's more high intensity. So you'll see a little bit more cardio moves involved in the warm-up. We're going to start a little bit slowly with the warm-up just to try to slowly kind of warm up safely, and then from there we'll add in some more high intensity exercises. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. If you don't have dumbbells, any other household items could work. Wine bottles, pantry cans that you have hanging around, water bottles that you could fill up, anything from there, like that works. All right, so we're gonna start with this warm up to get started. Soft bend in those knees, reach down to our toes, up to the sky as we come up and reach up. We're coming up onto our tippy toes to try to stretch out our calves and hamstrings. So up on our toes, back down and reach. Anything that feels comfortable for you just to get your body warmed up. If you have to bend your knees a little bit more to get down to that reach, totally fine. All right, take a wide stance here. Windmill motion, opposite fingertips come to opposite toes. Into running high knees. That running motion, bring those arms alternating back and front. Try and get those knees as high as you can. Extended warm up, working with some cardio moves right here. The rest of the workout focuses on strength. Here. to the wide stance here. Frogger jumps, chest stays tall. Arms stay straight down. Option, you can eliminate that jump. All right, just coming up into that power squat. Otherwise, add that small hop at the top. Three, two, and one. All right, working with some inchworms here. Arms come to the floor, walk out into that plank, and back. As we walk back, try to keep those knees as straight as possible.
So before we move from upper body to lower body and from lower body to core.
All right, so we have our dumbbells or equivalent, household bottles, anything like that. We're gonna start by going into an alternating bicep curl. All right, so coming up, once that comes down, ops down comes up. What we want to focus on is not using our core and our back to thrust that weight up. Core stays tight, soft bend in those standing knees. Opposite, alternating bicep curls. And we're going 10 on each side. All right, from here, we're going into a hip hinge. All right, so as if someone's poking right at the hips, butt drives back, flat back, shoulders down and relax. We're going into a high row. Weights come to chest, elbows come out, back down. Rotate so the palms face together to a low row. Weights come to hips, elbows drive back. All right, so high row, low row, that's one rep, and we have 10 of those. We're then going into a deadlift to upright row. So with that deadlift,
Again, those weights stay close to our body. Driving those hips back, soft bend in the knees. All right, that's the hip hinge motion. We're gonna complete a hip hinge. As we stand up, squeeze the glutes. Come right into an upright row, where we're just bringing those weights close to our body, right up to chest height and back down. All right, 10 there. We're then going into skier swings. All right, so hip hinge motion as we drag those weights back to work our triceps, and then the weights come up into chest height, almost like that hammer curl move. All right, 10 there. And then the final exercise is an overhead tricep dip. So we only need one weight, starting straight above our head, driving that weight straight back down our spine, pressing back up, down, back up. All right, so we have 10 there. Again, quick break, and we're gonna do that again for a second round only on 8 reps. All right, we got this. Starting with that, alternating bicep curls, soft bend in the knees. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. 10 on each side. Wrists rotate as you come up. Halfway there, slow and controlled movements. All right, we're not just dropping those weights. Last one on each side. All right. Going right into that hip hinge high to low row. All right. Butt drives back, flat back. Shoulders go down and relax. 3, 2, 1. Up and out. Down and back. Up and out. Down and back. Alternating those. Deadlift to upright row. 3, 2, 1. Reach down. As we come up into that upright row. Heels stay down, soft bend those knees. Last one. Whew. Good work. All right. Drop those weights, roll out those shoulders. You can roll out your neck, loosen up those arms. We're going for another round, 8 reps of every exercise here. All right, final work with the upper body. Pause for a second. All right, back into round two here. 8 reps. Alternating bicep curls. 3, 2, 1. Remember, core engaged here. Soft bend in those standing knees. Three more each. Last one here. All right, going right into that hip hinge, high to low row. All right, so as if someone's just poking us at the hips here, flat back, shoulders down and relax. 3, 2, 1. Up high to chest, down low to hips. 6 more. High, low. Last one. All right, stand up tall. Shake it out. Deadlift to upright row, soft bend in those knees, flat back. As we roll down, weights close to our legs. Drive up, upright row at the top. Over halfway through this one. 2 more. All right, right into those gear swings. Final 2 exercises of upper body work. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Hinge back as we press those weights back and come up. All right, that's 8. Drop 1 weight. Overhead tricep dip. Weight comes right down our spine. Don't arch that lower back. Tuck the tailbone under. Elbows get squeezed together. That's 2, 6 more. Shoulders, roll around the neck. We're done with the upper body work. Going right into that lower body block. All right. So the 5 exercises that we have here, we're starting with a goblet squat, also known as the front squat. We can hold that weight at our chest. All right. Squatting deep into that squat, heels stay down, knees driving over our toes. All right, just holding that weight at our chest. If you need to take this as a body weight squat and eliminate that weight, that's totally fine. Side view here, driving that butt back, knees coming over our toes, heels stay down. All right, we have 10 there. We're then going into alternating lunges, just with a dumbbell hold here. All right, so stepping forward and back. We're going 10 on each leg. All right, so 20 total there. And then we have the weight held here at our shoulders, and we're going into overhead thrusters. Squatting down, using power from our lower body, even adding in that hop to thrust those weights overhead. 10 total there. Final two exercises, we're going into a dumbbell hold lateral lunge. All right, so weights come on either side of that leg that's going into that lunge. Back up, and then we're doing it on the opposite side. All right, 10 on each side there. And then we're going into the final exercise, a dumbbell burpee. So as you hold those weights, the weights come to the floor, jump out, back in, stand up. That's one rep, jump out, in, and stand. Just holding onto the dumbbells the entire time. All right, your option here, just perform a regular burpee, drop the dumbbells. All right, totally fine to do it that way as well. All right, let's get started. Final roll of the shoulders, last sip of water. All right, starting with that goblet squat. Hold out our chest in 3, 2, 1. Coming back up. We're gonna go as low as your range of motion allows. When you feel your heels start coming off the floor, that's where you stop in your tracks and return up. Four more. All right. Alternating lunges. 10 on each side. 3, 2, 1. That back knee drives directly to point at the floor. Option here is also to drop those dumbbells. All right, just perform regular lunges. Halfway done, 5 more each leg. Option to walk your feet out and in as well. everyone. Stay strong. All right. Whew. Virtual high five. Awesome work, guys. Take those 30 seconds to rest. Shake it out, grab some water. Tough work with some strength here. All right. Lower that heart rate a little bit by slowing down your breathing. We have one more round. Again, at that 8 rep count. All right, so as we start to fatigue our body in these rounds, we decrease those reps that we're doing. Remember, if your body's totally feeling it here, you can make modifications. The goblet squat, both sets of those lunges, all of that can be done without weight. Same with the dumbbell burpee, standard burpee as well. All right, so if you feel like you need a little bit more ease on the effort that we're putting in, just drop those weights. All right, 8 reps here. Goblet squat, 3, 2, 1. Knees drive over toes, butt sits back, heels stay down, chest stays up. All right, that's 8. Grab the other side of the dumbbell, alternating lunges forward, 8 on each side. Front knee comes directly over those toes. Back knee directly at the floor. Halfway. If you're holding those weights, make sure your shoulders aren't shrugged. Down, back, and relaxed. Last one on each side. All right. Going right into those squat overhead thrusters. 3, 2, 1. Inhale, exhale. Last one. Whew. All right. Lateral lunges here. Again, options to drop those dumbbells if you need to. 3, 2, 1. Weights or hands around that leg into that lunge. Good work, guys. 2 more on each side. Whew. All right. Going right into the dumbbell burpee. Yeah, great. Dumbbell burpee. Perfect. All right. Spring up here where I thought we left off. All right. 8 here, final lower body work. 3, 2, 1. Coming down, show your feet back in and stand. Option, step each foot out and back in. More. work, guys. Whew. Shake it out. Shake out those legs. We have one final block. All right, going onto that core block, same thing. Two rounds, 10 reps the first round, 8 reps the second round, only 5 exercises. There, shake it out, hip bridge to crunch. We release that hip bridge before coming into that crunch. All right, 3, 2, 1, squeeze those glutes into that hip bridge, back down, crunch up. Bridge. Crunch. Eat more. One more. All right, sitting up tall, shake it out. All right, we're doing a full sit up to raising our feet here. All right, so starting down, feet flat on the floor. In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Sit up, feet come up, lower back down. Last one. All right. Going right into that rocking plank. 30 seconds here. All right. We're going to start it in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Tops of our toes, balls of our feet, flat back as we rock back and forth. Work, guys. All right, grab that sip of water. We have one final round. All right, we've been working for just almost 37 minutes. All right, we have one more round in us. 8 reps of 5 exercises. We got it. This is the finish line. Go work, guys. All right, let's finish this strong. 8 reps here. All right, already easier than that last round as we take some reps off. Starting with that overhead double crunch, adding in that weight. If you dropped your weight, try to add it back in here. All right, even if it's just for the first 2 reps and you have to drop it after that, small changes. All right, starting laying flat back, weight overhead. Double crunch up, 3, 2, 1, you're for 8. Last one. All right, again, into those oblique rows. Deep twist into each side, whether you're using a weight or not. 8 on each side, 3, 2, 1. More. raise at the top. All right, 8 total in 3, 2, 1. Sit up, raise those feet, slow and control back down. same size of that leg. Kickstand out on our heel. Come back so you can see. Kickstand on our heel. Both hands reach down, grab our toes. Soft bend in that opposite knee too. Slowly roll up. Opposite leg comes up. We're going to continue doing some more quad and hamstring stretches on the floor. So if you feel like you need a little bit more here, as we move from stretch to stretch, don't worry. We're going to continue to stretch it out with a couple more exercises on the floor after this one. Kickstand that heel out. Both hands reach down towards our toes. You could also grab your ankle if your range of motion doesn't allow. Slowly roll up. All right, coming down to the floor. One leg is gonna come straight back. One leg's gonna bend here in front of us. All right, you can stay on your palms. If your range of motion allows, come down onto our elbows. You'll feel this stretch through our glutes, our quads, a little bit into our hamstrings. Holding in here a few more seconds. Coming back up to our palms, kick that front leg back. Opposite leg comes forward. The leg behind us is completely straight. Same thing, if we can, come down onto our elbows to feel it deeper into that stretch. Still focus on your breath here, slowly in through our nose, out through our mouth. One foot comes to the opposite side of that knee. We're gonna rotate opposite direction. Opposite side. Opposite leg comes to the other side of that knee. Rotate opposite direction. A little bit further out.
come back to that neutral flat back position. We're going to lean back onto our knees, sitting back. Reach as far out as you can with our hands. Drop that head, relax that head and neck. Back to that neutral position. Step both legs in. Slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. As we come up, we reach overhead. Deep inhale through our nose. And exhale out. Thank you guys so much for coming. Happy Monday. This workout, if you're joining us late, is going to be saved on our Instagram TV and also on our YouTube page. Hope you guys have a great rest of your Monday. Our next workout is Wednesday at 5:30. We also have a Friday at noon. But thank you guys so much, and I will see you soon.